Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. Je m'appelle David Ragsdale. Je suis maréchal de l'université et je suis heureux de vous accueillir au nom de l'Université McGill à la cérémonie de collation de grade du printemps 2023 pour la faculté de médecine. La cérémonie va bientôt commencer. My name is David Ragsdale. I'm a university marshal, and I am pleased to welcome you on behalf of McGill University to the Spring 2023 convocation ceremony for the Faculty of Medicine. The ceremony will start shortly. Dans quelques instants, je vous parlerai de la séquence des événements qui se dérouleront pendant la cérémonie. Mais permettez-moi d'abord de vous demander de vous joindre à moi pour applaudir the Brian Sand Quintet. In just a few moments, I will tell you about the sequence of events that will take place during the ceremony. But first, let me ask you to join me in giving the Brian Sand Quintet a very warm round of applause. La cérémonie commencera avec l'entrée de la fête de la plateforme et se terminera avec son départ. Et juste avant que le cortège d'honneur n'entre, je vous demanderai à tous de vous lever. The ceremony will begin with the entrance of the platform party and end with its departure. And just before the platform party enters, I will ask you all to stand. Une fois que les membres du cortège d'honneur auront pris place ici sur scène, le professeur Trevino chantera l'hymne universitaire. Once the members of the platform party have taken their places on the stage, Professor Trevino will sing the university song. Le chancelier John McCall McBain ainsi que le principal Deep Saney prononcera chacun quelques mots. Quelques prix seront remis, suivis du discours de collection de grade français par le récipiendaire d'un doctorat honorifique. The Chancellor, John McCall McBain, as well as the Principal, Deep Saney, will each say a few words. Some awards will be presented, followed by the convocation address given by the honorary degree recipient. Nous procéderons ensuite à la remise des diplômes rang par rang, en partant de l'avant et en remontant vers l'arrière. We will then proceed to award the diplomas row by row, starting from the front and moving toward the back. Diplômé, vous serez guidé hors de vos sièges au moment opportun. Avant de monter sur scène, vous devez séparer votre carte de nom en deux. Vous remettre en partie au lecteur ou à la personne qui assiste le lecteur au pupitre à votre gauche. Et après avoir traversé la scène, vous remettre l'autre partie à la personne en bas des escaliers qui vous remettra votre diplôme. Graduates, you will be guided out of your seat at the appropriate time. Before going on stage, you should separate your lineup card in two. You will give one part to the reader or to the person assisting the reader at the lectern on your left. And after crossing the stage, you will give the other part to the person at the bottom of the stairs who will give you your degree. Pour terminer la cérémonie, la secrétaire générale, Edita Rogowska, prononcera quelques remarques de clôture. Le professeur Trevino dirigera le chant de l'hymne national et le cortège d'honneur suivra le joueur de cornemuse jusqu'au campus. To end the ceremony, the Secretary General, Edita Rogowska, will make a few closing remarks. Professor Trevino will lead the singing of the national anthem, and the platform party will follow the bagpiper out onto the campus. Une fois que le cortège d'honneur est parti, les diplômés partiront ensuite rangé par rangé, en commençant par la rangée arrière et en continuant vers l'avant. Voulez ne pas essayer de sortir tant qu'un huissier ne pas indiquer qu'il est temps pour votre rangée de partir. Once the platform party has left, the degree recipients will then leave row by row, starting with the back rows and proceeding toward the front. Please do not try to exit until an usher has indicated it's time for your row to leave. J'invite maintenant le vice-dean Mélanie Mondou à vous informer des mesures de sécurité mises en place dans le cas très improbable d'une urgence. I now invite Vice Dean Mélanie Mondou to inform you of the safety precautions put in place in the very unlikely event of an emergency. Mélanie.
Welcome to McGill and this year's convocation. Congratulations on the success of your graduating family member or friend. My name is Mélanie Mondou and I'm the Associate Dean Undergraduate Medical Education, and my role is to tell you about our emergency evacuation procedures. Bienvenue à McGill et à la cérémonie de la collation des grades de cette année. Nous sommes ravis de vous accueillir. Je m'appelle Mélanie Mondou, je suis la vice-doyenne aux études médicales de premier cycle et on m'a demandé de vous informer des procédures d'évacuation d'urgence mises en place. If an evacuation is required, the registrar will announce this to you. You will then be required to leave the tent immediately. Please follow the instructions of security officers and ushers. Please do not follow the graduates. They will be evacuated to a different location. Ushers and security officers will lead you to the field across the street from the tent. Leave all baby strollers behind, but please take your children with you. You may refer to the evacuation map on the back of your program for more information. If you need assistance at any point, please speak to our usher or security officer. Once the emergency is over, information will be posted on www.mcgill.ca to inform you of what will happen next. Si une évacuation des lieux devenait nécessaire, la registrar en ferait l'annonce. Vous devriez alors quitter la tente sans tarder. Suivez les instructions des placeurs et de la sécurité. Ne suivez pas les diplômés, car ils seront dirigés dans un autre pavillon. Les placeurs et les agents de sécurité vous dirigeront sur le terrain en face de la tente. Laissez toutes les poussettes sur place, mais n'oubliez pas vos enfants. Vous trouverez le plan d'évacuation au verso du programme. Si vous avez besoin d'assistance, veuillez vous adresser à un agent de sécurité ou à un placeur. Une fois la situation d'urgence passée, des annonces seront publiées sur le site www.mcgill.ca. Je vous remercie de votre attention. Félicitations aux diplômés. Thank you for your attention. Have a nice, wonderful, and once again, congratulations to all our graduates.
Nous allons maintenant recevoir un court message de l'Association des diplômés de McGill. We will now have a short message from the McGill Alumni Association.
As an alumnus, I'm proud to celebrate your McGill journey, and I echo the sentiments of everyone who ever graduated from our university with just three words.
You made it.
As a graduate, you're part of something unique, the McGill Alumni Association.
Profiterez donc des avantages auxquels ont droit tous les diplômés et serez ainsi prêt à écrire un nouveau chapitre de votre vie.
Your Alumni Association is an amazing community of more than 300,000 alumni
in over 180 countries.
The global network that we share opens up a world of possibilities and connections.
L'Association des diplômés de McGill propose également des activités stimulantes et vous guidera avec des activités enrichissantes de mentorat et de réseautage.
Whether you're near campus or halfway around the world, you can easily stay connected through the MAA. Just follow us on social media and share your news.
We are here to celebrate you, cheer you on, and help you reach your next milestones.
Welcome.
Bienvenue parmi nous.
Bienvenue parmi nous.
And congratulations on being a part of McGill's graduating class of 2023. Bienvenue aux nouveaux diplômés et félicitations à la promotion 2023 de McGill.
Le cortège d'honneur sera bientôt en route et je vous demanderai de vous lever quand les seront proches. Merci. Voulez-vous lever? Please stand.
if God will. Queen of the colleges, dear old McGill.
Agwego wat kuno uradu. Nega dewa e doske uan uni zarade, nene yuri huanu, neji was wado hetste no de zoyo daje. Nexi din dewa e ha, agwego zini tuga izo e suan uni zarade, agwego wat kuno uradu. Tiniji da kana raje, agwe se yugo da garide. Nono da shadora te oga de nujera zi taniot. Neji gigo ostawa kawi, ne wa e dawana duka yeti nistan huza. Tanu jini jiji dasu jim zade jinyore ne uwa wini zarade segu agwegu ya gotka wa haje dana ya tano jodukte. Nona dasa tum gaure enaga no hodu gharuni agwegu ne segu tani jiro di daje nioni. Wanek kari wa nota ne chate wini zarage onek ti daye dadunu waradu. Ona na ne jini gane ga jokka agwegu agwegu aska ne ado wawet nuni nukwa nigura danu da tsiduna waradu. No hodu da wana duko ne so yeru ga sasara goa. Sugoya dizu. Ne gadi wahi. Chatku, ne yugoya nioni ne garana suwa. Agwegu ga idwes uwa winizarade ne tinya degu adawage. Tinigane asa ni goda noza. Chunheku. Onagi astuwa ne agadara nodo. Ne zitonuere zi agwe yugwa tsanuni. Seated. I'd just like to translate what I just said. So following the ancient treaty protocols, whenever various nations meet, we acknowledge each and every one of us that are gathered here at this particular moment in time. As we look around, we're all seemingly in good mind, good health, good spirit. And when you weigh that out and you ask yourself, well, why is that? We have our own creation story that we call Turtle Island, which is also Mother Earth, because we are at her bosom, all of us as children. And she gives us pure, unconditional love every day that comes in the form of water, of medicines, of plants, of corn, of beans, of squash, of animals, of trees and birds. And when we look up into the sky, we acknowledge the four winds. We acknowledge our grandfather, the thunder beings. We acknowledge our elder brother, the sun. We acknowledge our grandmother, the moon. We acknowledge the stars, the star knowledge, the star stories, the star people. When we go beyond that, now we acknowledge all of those ancestors that have come and gone before us, that are all part of that sacred energy. And now we ask all that sacred energy, all that power, all that strength to continue to do its work, duty, and responsibility so that we can dance and be happy in this life. You just heard a ceremonial song that we call Una Uzara Neha, which is connected to the pumpkins and the squashes, the three sisters, because all of us got to eat every day. None of us can eat money. And what we do, the people of the Longhouse, is all about dancing to creation, dancing to life, and how beautiful it is that we are all still here in each other's sacred presence. So with that, I just want to acknowledge and wish you all the best in health, happiness, peace, love, and joy. So let us have this in our minds. Nyawakoa, merci beaucoup. Thank you very much.
Good morning. And thank you, Elder Kevin Deere, for being at today's ceremony and for your opening remarks. We are grateful for your presence here, and thank you and Professor Trevino for the wonderful performance of the University Song. So I'd like to start this, these proceedings by reminding you that McGill University is on the land which has long served as a site of meeting and exchange among Indigenous people, including the Haudenosaunee and the Anishinaabe nations. We acknowledge and thank the diverse Indigenous people whose presence marks this territory on which peoples of the world now gather. Bienvenue à tous les diplômés, leurs familles et leurs proches amis, notre nouveau principal et vice-chancelier Deep Sani, M. Ram Panda, qui est le président émérité du Conseil des gouverneurs et membre de la faculté. À titre de chancelier et au nom de l'Université McGill, bienvenue à notre magnifique campus au centre-ville de Montréal pour célébrer la cérémonie de remise de diplôme 2023 des facultés de médecine dentaire et des sciences de la santé orale et médecine et sciences de la santé. As Chancellor McGill University, I welcome you to our beautiful downtown campus in Montreal to celebrate the class of 2023 graduating from the faculties of Dental Medicine and Oral Health Sciences and Medicine Health Sciences. And maybe a special welcome to all those friends, families, and visitors who are joining us not only from Montreal, but from around the world. But first, let me first welcome and congratulate all the graduates that are here today. I could not be more pleased or proud to share this day with you and your family, friends, and classmates. But today, I would like to answer one question. Why are we here? Pourquoi nous sommes ici? À première vue, c'est évident. Nous sommes ici parce que nos enfants et les amis nous ont demandé de venir assister à cette célébration de leur réussite ou parce que nous devons y assister en tant que diplômés, membres de la faculté ou administrateurs. So at first glance, it seems simple why we're here. It seems obvious. We're here because our son or daughter or friend is graduating and they told us to be here to celebrate the graduation. Or we are supposed to be here because we're graduates, faculty and administration. So here we are. Let the proceedings begin. Alors, allons-y. On reflection, however, as graduates, faculty, administration, parents, and friends, we are here for many important reasons. Let me take a few minutes to discuss the seven real reasons we're here that really brought us together here to celebrate. First, yes, we're here to celebrate personal achievement. These graduates have worked hard. The university has given its graduates stronger cognitive skills to cultivate and nurture creative minds. This will lead to confident graduates who will find personal success and well-being with their career, family, and friends in our society, hopefully making better personal decisions along the way. So yes, we're here to celebrate the achievements of individual graduates on the road to future success. Congratulations. Félicitations pour le succès personnel de chaque diplômé. Mais deuxièmement, nous sommes ici pour célébrer la mobilité sociale. Secondly, however, we're also here to celebrate social mobility. Public universities like McGill are an engine of social mobility and economic vitality. Every student today who crosses this stage and emerges on the other side becomes a role model for what is possible for every one of us. The university is in the business of changing family trees, one leaf at a time. Third, we're here to celebrate the university's role in the collective societal goal of producing educated citizens. Our communities are direct beneficiaries of our student citizenship to help each of us engage with each other in an informed and rigorous debate about our communities. Our overall governance will be improved with engaged and informed citizens. Les citoyens éduqués et informés sont une chance pour une meilleure gouvernance de notre société. The fourth reason we're here is to celebrate the teachers of teachers. The systematic renewal and improvement of our society depends on great teachers, both in universities, but also in primary and high school education. And guess where this starts? Right here at the university, teaching teachers. So we're also here to celebrate those who teach the teachers. Nous célébrons ensemble les enseignants et enseignantes. The fifth reason we're here is to celebrate the role of the university in economic development of our communities, of our nations. For example, McGill University is a major economic driver for Montreal and Quebec directly and via its affiliated teaching hospitals. McGill and other Canadian universities are also important economic drivers worldwide, and indeed, not just in Canada, but in other countries. Le rôle des universités comme moteur économique est également important. The sixth reason we're here is to celebrate truth, la vérité. Universities are the guardians of reason. The research and innovation of universities, both as stewards and repositories of human knowledge, as well as their role in disseminating research on the frontiers of knowledge, make universities essential to learning even more truths about our world. And finally, the seventh reason we're here, and perhaps the most important, is that public universities have a public purpose as essential and pivotal change agents for the long-term well-being of our society. Le rôle des universités comme acteurs de changement est fondamental pour notre société. We must assure that universities are not only knowledge disseminators, but are also wisdom creators. In the future, will depend on universities' role as change agents for both our society to increase its diversity, equity, and inclusion, but also for the planet and its long-term sustainability in the face of the ravages of climate change. So in summary, we're here today to celebrate the university and its graduates for seven reasons. So when you go back to the worksite, or go back in the office, or return to your hometown, and somebody asks you, why were you in Montreal the other day? You can give them the good seven reasons, and maybe they'll be excused from work. So those seven reasons were personal achievement, succès personnel, mobilité sociale, social mobility, educated citizens, citoyen éduqué et informé, teacher of the teachers, enseignante des enseignantes, economic development, moteur économique, and truth, la vérité, and change agents, les acteurs de changement. So to the friends and the parents of graduates, you did it too. Enjoy this moment, shed a tear, it'll be very hard to avoid. And to the graduates, as you're walking out of here, take a second look up at the sun to enjoy this moment in life. It may be only one you get to shed a little tear and enjoy this moment. Truly enjoy it. That tear is the water of a life well lived. Félicitations, la promotion 2023. Congratulations to the 2023 graduates. Merci and thank you. It is now my pleasure to invite Deep Sani, the newly installed, as of yesterday, Principal and Vice Chancellor of McGill University, to address the audience. J'aimerais maintenant inviter Deep Sani, Principal et Vice-Chancellier de l'Université McGill, à s'adresser à l'auditoire. Deep?
Good morning. Bonjour. Bienvenue et félicitations à nos finissantes et finissants de la promotion de 2023. Congratulations to the class of 2023. And let me offer a warm welcome to you all, your families and friends, as well as to our esteemed guests who have joined us today. Quel plaisir de célébrer ensemble vos réalisations, les réalisations de nos étudiants. And what an honor it is for me to be standing here to preside over my first convocation ceremonies as the principal and vice chancellor of McGill University, this great institution that we so love. It feels like just yesterday that I too was a proud McGill parent sitting under this big tent, like many of you are today, as I watched my daughter receive her McGill degree. So to the families and to friends, I know the feeling that you're going through today. I know it very well. Being a McGill graduate is a distinction not easily earned. It requires diligence, determination, and commitment. You have demonstrated all of these qualities throughout your studies, and even more so during the pandemic. You adapted with agility to these unprecedented circumstances. You met these difficulties with strength and prevailed to reach your goal. In reaching this milestone, take a moment to really appreciate the meaning and weight of your achievements. Be proud of yourselves for your remarkable efforts and resilience. Relish in the excitement, even in those nervous feelings that come with a future that is full of possibilities and also uncertainties. And importantly, recognize the many people who have helped you get here, your family and your friends, who supported you in your studies, as well as our professors, librarians, and university staff. So at this moment, ladies and gentlemen, our graduates, let's put our hands together in a big applause, big round of applause to those who have supported you. Chers finissants, vous avez mérité une place bien à vous dans l'histoire de notre université. Depuis plus de 200 ans, cette histoire s'enrichit de l'excellence de nos étudiants et des étudiantes, professeurs, membres du personnel et bien entendu de nos diplômés. This greatness, which I have had the pleasure of witnessing firsthand since I joined the university in April, is what I call that very special McGill character. Graduates, take what you have learned during your time at McGill and use your education to leave this imperfect world better than you found it. And always make sure that the opportunities afforded by your education do not enhance your life alone, but also the lives of others. I recognize this is a big ask and meeting it will not be easy. Doing so will indeed demand a great deal of effort and character on your part. But your generation has demonstrated time and again that you have what it takes to effect real transformative change. Finissantes et finissants, nous avons aujourd'hui beaucoup de raisons de célébrer, car aujourd'hui, vous devenez les diplômés de McGill. Vous vous joignez à un réseau actif composé de quelques 300 000 personnes établies un peu partout dans le monde. Je vous invite à maintenir un lien fort avec votre alma mater. Ensemble, nous continuerons à façonner le troisième siècle de McGill. This is a community that is renowned for questioning established paradigms, for embracing difficult challenges, and constantly pushing the frontiers of creativity and innovation, and always with a focus on improving the societies it serves. Graduates, as you begin your next chapter in your lives, think of how you can leverage this special McGill character which each of you embodies to make your communities and our world a better place. More than ever, our world needs bright, passionate, creative, and empathetic people. People who are capable and driven to address the pressing challenges of our time, challenges such as transitioning the world to more sustainable energy sources, developing new frameworks to ensure the more ethical use of artificial intelligence, or safeguarding our democracy and civil order in this post-truth era, and a lot more. So graduates, the future is yours to shape. Follow your curiosity wherever it may lead, and above all, keep learning. We cannot wait to hear where your journey takes you and the stellar things you will no doubt achieve along the way. Alors, félicitations, congratulations to you all the best.
Not bad for his first time, eh? Very good. That's great. So, under your seat, you got markers between 1 and 10. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you, Principal Sandy. We'll now proceed with the teaching award presentations. I invite Elham Amami, the Dean of the Faculty of Dental Medicine and Oral Health Sciences, to present the first award winner. And then next, Melanie Mondeau, Associate Dean of Undergraduate Medical Education, will present our second award winner. And then when your names are mentioned, I invite the winners to stand when their name is called and join the principal at the front of the stage. Dean Amami.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Julia Cohen-Levy. Dr. Cohen-Levy is a clinician scientist in the field of orthodontics and sleep medicine. She's committed to teaching and training of our students to treat patients who suffer from malocclusion and craniofacial diseases. She is recipient of the W.W. Wood Award for Excellence in Dental Education in 2022 and the prestigious Dr. Lorf Silverstone Teaching Award in 2023. Dr. Cohen-Levy uses clay models to illustrate concepts related to biomechanics, and she also employs creative mnemonic techniques to help her students learn. Her teaching philosophy is based on the meiotic approach, which involves using the Socratic method to develop clinical thinking skills through questioning and inquiry. To foster a supportive learning environment, she encourages active participation and uses humor to promote psychological safety. In addition, she has designed mock board exam sessions that simulate the stress of real exams, followed by strategies to help her students cope with test anxiety. She has also been actively building a sense of community within our faculty through recent initiatives such as Un franc sourire during the Journée Internationale de la Francophonie. I would like to conclude by citing her students. She takes the time to teach things in a way that you will remember because she forces you to think about what you are doing and what you are doing and why you are doing it. But she doesn't ever make you feel stupid. If anything, she boosts your confidence. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is my great pleasure to present Dr. Julia Cohen-Levy, winner of the Howard S. Katz Award for Excellence in Teaching, Faculty of Dental Medicine and Oral Health Sciences.
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Matthew Walker. Dr. Matthew Walker obtained his Bachelor of Arts and Medical degrees from McGill University. He completed residencies in internal medicine and cardiology at McGill and completed a fellowship in advanced echocardiography at the Montreal Heart Institute. He joined the Division of Cardiology at St. Mary's Hospital in 2006 and is currently Associate Professor of Medicine. He has been the course director for the circulation course for undergraduate medical students since 2006. He was also the co-director of the McGill Cardiology Residency Program from 2010 to 2015. Dr. Walker is currently the divisional director at the Cardiology Division at St. Mary's Hospital. He was the recipient of the Faculty of Medicine Osler Award for Outstanding Teaching in 2011 and named to the Faculty Honor List for Educational Excellence in 2017. In 2021, Dr. Walker was the recipient of the George Fraser Memorial Award in recognition of excellence in teaching and dedicated patient care. Mr. Vice Chancellor, it is my honor to present Dr. Matthew Walker, winner of the Osler Award for Outstanding Teaching in the Faculty of Medicine.
Thank you to the presenters, and of course, congratulations to this year's winners. Again, teachers, for their well-deserved recognition and the recognition of teaching as a profession itself. We'll now proceed with the honorary degree presentation. McGill University is honored today to celebrate the achievements of Amalia Tewatonti McGregor. I will ask David Eidelman, the Vice Principal of Health and Affairs and Dean of the Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, to present our distinguished guests so that they may have conferred upon them the highest recognition is within the power of the university to grant. And I ask Amalia to join me at the center stage for the presentation of the honorary degree. Thank you. Dean Edelman.
Mr. Chancellor, I present to you Amalia Tewatonti McGregor. Thanks to the breadth and depth of her knowledge and experience, Amalia McGregor has made vital contributions to the expanding fields of Indigenous research methodology, health promotion, and community education. A wife, mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, elder, and treasured knowledge holder of Haudenosaunee ways and teachings, Mrs. McGregor, a Mohawk from Ganawage, is a revered community leader known for her wise counsel. Il y a près de 30 ans, elle a joué un rôle important dans l'élaboration d'un programme d'éducation en santé susceptible de sauver des vies. Mrs. McGregor helped create the Ganawage School's Diabetes Prevention Project in 1994, an award-winning response to alarming rates of type 2 diabetes in the Ganawage community. This disease emerged as a significant public health threat in many Indigenous communities during the latter half of the 20th century. And today, type 2 diabetes is 2 to 5 times more prevalent among Indigenous Canadians than in the general population. The project focuses on the prevention of type 2 diabetes in young people, but also contributes to research by sharing data with both its community and researchers through partnerships between Ganawage and universities. Data are also shared with other Indigenous communities, as well as organizations focused on diabetes prevention. The project operates in harmony with Genyagaha values. Mrs. McGregor has also developed its code of research ethics, setting standards in the field. In 2019, the Ganawage School's Diabetes Prevention Project received the Organization Achievement Award for Health Promotion from Health Promotion Canada, which recognizes organizations that have made significant contributions to addressing issues of health equity in Canadian communities. For decades, Amalia McGregor has shared her knowledge for the next generation, nurturing their understanding of how important it is to uphold Indigenous identity and perspective within academic institutions in the wider healthcare landscape. She has framed learning and education as a lifelong journey while recognizing some of our most valuable teachings can be found outside the classroom. Over the past quarter century, she has mentored numerous undergraduate, master's, and doctoral students, as well as postdoctoral fellows. Mrs. McGregor serves as knowledge holder on several related tri-council grants, helping guide research activities and decision-making. Today, she is recognized as a national leader in Indigenous community-based diabetes prevention, health promotion, and culturally relevant education. Ses contributions importantes en recherche ont porté fruit en matière de santé autochtone et ont été essentielles au développement de partenariats de recherche éthique entre les communautés autochtones et le monde universitaire. Amalia McGregor's steadfast work to champion the voice of Indigenous peoples ensuring the infusion of traditional indigenous understanding and practices within academic research and health and education leaves a vast, a lasting and valuable legacy. Mr. Chancellor, I present to you Amelia Dequadundi McGregor so that you may confer upon her the degree of Doctor of Science, honoris causa.
So I'd like to now invite Alex McComber, Assistant Professor of Family Medicine, Hooder of the Honorary Doctorate, to the podium to present Mrs. McGregor with an eagle feather as a gift from her community.
Hi.
Hi. You have the gift. You want to speak? Okay.
Sego Zuwaguego. I'd like to invite Gunnarat Tidake and Guizayande, two of Amelia McGregor's daughters. Dr. Trina DeLormier, Associate Professor at the School of Human Nutrition. Lisa Peterson, the Ganawagi School's Diabetes Prevention Program Chairperson, and Thomasina Phillips from the Office of Indigenous Initiatives and First Peoples House to join on stage for this presentation. Right up. Right. Come and sit down. They will be presenting the feather, Trina. And so this gift, Amelia, honors your tremendous contributions to Ganawage and indigenous communities and also to the academic world, recognizing the significance of everything you've accomplished and shared with our peoples and with the settlers and allies and people who come to learn. And you've always shared that with love and in that most respectful way. In our ways, in our cultures, the eagle, Agwex, is a very special creature. The vision of the eagle is known, and that power and wisdom of the eagle in our traditional teachings of the Haudenosaunee, we say that the eagle sits on top of the tree of peace, and it, with its vision, watches out in all directions to see that the people are safe. And if there's any danger or calamity that comes, the eagle then takes flight to warn the people of the impending danger so that they can gather and find the good solutions to that. And so we recognize that Agwex, our brother, sister, carries that great medicine, and to honor and acknowledge someone with an eagle feather is of the highest importance and honor. And so the people at McGill University, at the Office of Indigenous Initiatives, and in the offices proposed that we come together and gift Amelia with this feather, and with the support and on behalf of her family and colleagues and the people of Ganawagi. And because that feather itself is that recognition of not only this accomplishment of teachings, but also it represents what's behind that, which is the love, which is the skana, that peace that we carry, ganigurio, that good mind that we're responsible to be with. It carries with it that gosestansera, the gifts that we're given for our earth journey, and reminds us to carry these forward in the best way. And also that ganardunquatsera, that great love that binds us all together that my brother referred to earlier as well in those opening words. And so, Amelia, with this eagle feather, we gift you with that, with the greatest of honor and thrill and happiness from your family and friends and from the community at McGill University, your colleagues here. And this feather then carries a responsibility with it. It's just not a decoration. It's not an ornament. Feathers carry power. They carry teachings. They carry gifts. And we believe that eagle feathers find their way to their owners. And so this has been destined, this has been determined through that great mystery that binds us all together, that this was going to come together today. So that Amelia, you and that eagle feather now get to know each other and come to learn each other and guide, and that feather will guide you as you continue on your journey. So Ganarunkwa, sister, Nyawa Goa, Zawa Guego.
It's actually my pleasure now to invite Amelia to come up and offer the convocation address. In a moment. Yes.
Oh my God, I'm on the thing, the speaker. Okay.
Go ahead.
All right. What kuno waradu sa wagwego kasi what's kodo tano ojage kuna tahus sa den sa tuwa thara gistumha te kodo di yujats tano na diskarewa kaya niwa kita roda tut kuti tano te tuwa dasa wana gistumha kawa na hetsto nega ang kujato roro. Te keno rahdo si wagwego kas what's kodo tano oni keno nukwa agwego akwajule runa dahusa de dugani runa dororo kika tano ona te ora stunga ke wano ets tene ka asika eti no rahdo oni ne finis di tinis taha yuhu jade jinora jinoska tindia gwego jagot ka waga kaya nene to watch tane kanyo ke haka hinja doda tano oni de tinorado tsugoya dizum tinori oskats tinja gwego de sugawi ne skana ka ni go riu tano ne kasats tansa ne do watsta ne jogo de waskana tinji de do wathar tan jo skana tinji de do jo do ro jogo de toni oton kwa ni gura. So it's at this time that I introduce myself, and it's customary whenever we greet each other, these are some of the words that we pass, as Kanasom already started with, and I'm just continuing with adding a few of my own words to that. So at this time, I'd like to give you words from the chancellor, the principal, and the past chair, and all these people, the McGill School Board of Governors, and family and guests, as well as the graduates of the class of 2023. Greetings to everybody. Yoskats jinjukang jukajatoro ji yatatu yuraku de atste dano yungweza. And I'm just saying that to greet this beautiful morning that we're standing here today. So I'm standing here because 28 years ago, the Combined School Committee was looking for a member to attend a meeting of this Combined School Committee, and was looking for, about this new diabetes prevention project starting in Ganawage. I volunteered to become one of the members to come and listen to some of the presentations that were given by community and to fight for the diabetes that was only then being recognized as an epidemic in Ganawage and among indigenous people. I attended a as a school committee member and as a mother and as a grandmother and as a great-grandmother, as they already said, and concerned about the health of our children and grandchildren. I saw firsthand the negative power of diabetes that had afflicted my mother. And so I watched her when she went through from January to June, being in the hospital and finally getting an opportunity to come home and be home for 2 days, and she passed away in her sleep because that's all she wanted was to come home. And she got her wish. And so the project leaders explained this was a community participatory research project. It was to be an equal partnership between scientists and the community. One of the government evaluators who was present was pushing the project made leads to compare research results between the children attending two of our schools, something the community had told the team was not an acceptable practice, as that person kept insisting. I finally spoke up as a community member and pointed point blank that the person that if the Gunawage Combined School Committee and the community said no, oh wow, it's really loud. Okay, and the community said no to comparing our students. What part did they not understand? Because we decide what is best for our children, not the outsiders. And so our diabetes prevention program has continued successfully without ever comparing our children. I began attending the community advisory board meetings and never looked back. They keep offering me coffee, so of course, I'm not gonna say no, right? So anyway, where was I? Eventually, as the community members were invited to participate in different projects coming from KSDPP, I found myself participating and being asked for my thoughts and opinions by people who were truly interested in what I and others have to say about health and wellness, children and education, community involvement, roles and responsibilities of people, and so many other topics that come from our traditional ways and understanding of our relationships with all of the natural life. And so there's a pause here. Okay, so the next thing I knew, I was being invited to different projects on diabetes prevention and community mobilization, as well as health promotion. And I was meeting these awesome students who wanted to help and who were interested in learning more about us, and with real interest to learn from the communities and other projects working for the same cause, to ensure our future generations are healthier than we are. And over the years, as we have discussed ethics, research methodologies, decision making and consensus building and other concepts, the space for Indigenous and community participation has grown, and our voice bringing teachings from our ancestors has gotten louder and stronger. It is an honor to provide opening words and to bring greetings to local, national, and international gatherings. It's important we continue to share our teachings, to hear the teachings of other peoples, and to be able to come together to discuss different views with aspects, respect, love, and using our good minds for healthy futures. I offer my thanks and appreciation to McGill University for the recognition of this honorary doctorate and to people who submitted my name for this honor. I offer my congratulations to all of the graduates gathered today and during this graduation season. What you have learned on your journey, you are now responsible to give back to the people. Remember that what you say and do will have an impact on 7 generations into the future. I listen to all perspectives of the topics with respect and love and an open mind and be willing to work together to find the best decisions for the well-being of everyone. Nyawa. Suwagwego ga suwats gordo. Nyawa jiwas kwas tumusa de tuniyawanage to.
Thank you, Mrs. McGregor, and I think she said 2 things that sort of interest me, and maybe she gave one to the graduates, which was be responsible, you're responsible to giving back. But then she said that we also want to ensure that future generations are healthier than our own. And I think that for the medical students, that's probably another goal which you mentioned, which I think we could also pass on to the graduates. I'd like now to proceed with a conferral of the academic degrees. Christopher Manfredi, the Provost and Vice Principal Academic, will begin the formal proceedings. Christopher?
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. I am pleased to invite students graduating from the faculties of Dental Medicine and Oral Health Sciences and Medicine and Health Sciences for the conferral of degrees. Convocation is a truly joyous event in the cycle of the university's life, particularly at McGill, where we have such talented and accomplished students. Each student crossing the stage will be greeted by the chancellor, the principal, or the chair emeritus of the Board of Governors. Students receiving their first degree shall remove their mortarboard or hat. At center stage, they will be symbolically capped, signaling ceremonially the conferral of the degree. Students who have already earned a university degree keep their mortarboard on and will be congratulated by a tap on the shoulder. The parchment or degree itself is given to students after they have a photo taken and leave the stage. You may see, and you have seen, some students wearing red or white scarves. All self-identifying Indigenous students, First Nations, Inuit, and Métis, are entitled to wear graduation scarves at convocation, in the community, and at any and all future McGill events that they attend. This spring convocation, we are proud to welcome 71 new Indigenous graduates to the community of McGill alumni. En vertu des pouvoirs qui me sont conférés par le Sénat de McGill, je déclare que les candidats dont le nom figure sur la liste officielle des diplômés de l'université, qu'ils soient présents ou absents, ont satisfait aux exigences de leur grade, diplôme ou certificat respectif. By virtue of the powers conferred upon me by McGill Senate, I declare that the candidates whose names appear on the university's official list of graduates, whether they be present or absent, have satisfied the requirements for the respective degrees, diplomas, or certificates. By tradition at McGill, we begin with students receiving graduate degrees, followed by students obtaining undergraduate degrees. I now invite Dr. Samuel Benaroya to present the graduates. Congratulations, class of 2023. Félicitations.
There's another. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Craniofacial Health Sciences, Faculty of Dental Medicine and Oral Health Sciences, Bassem Danish. For the degree of Master of Science in Dental Sciences, Swetha Balasubramani. Daria Davari Logan. Fatime Keshani. Hamid Nabavi. Amina Nizar Bima. Swetha Sherigar. Clay Smith. Madhura Tandal. Amir Zargaran. For the degree of Doctor of Dental Medicine, Aya Abdelkarim. Masilia Abibsi. Ziad Alazmar. Angel Azizi. Vita Bardal, Dean's Honor List. Sophie Benhamron. Sabrina Bufergen. Yasmin Shiban. Pearly Dayson. Hannah Evans. Elana Fogel. Sydney Hetherington. Amir Jalayer. Sarah Kamali. Bushra Khan. Niloufar Kuhestanian. Albert Lay. James Lee. Kwangjun Thomas Lee. Lisa Ma. Martin Mangoni. Ashish Nair, Dean's Honor List. Tuan Nguyen. Sotiris Sam Sikaris. Rekha Vishnavi Ravindrakumar. Cindy Rubiar. Joel Rogozinski. Hisham Sabri. Asya Tsivian Diapko. Tatiana Tucinardi. Tiffany Wang. Yifei Wang. Fariz Yazigi, Dean's Honor List. George Yazigi, Dean's Honor List. Hanwen Yu. Toka Zaini. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Biological and Biomedical Engineering, Faculty of Medicine and Health Sciences, Aline Domin. Jacqueline Court Mascor. Reza Rasuli. David Sharon. Michelle Tran. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Biomedical Engineering, Omid Zoberi. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Biostatistics, Yi Lian. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Communication Sciences and Disorders, Yondu Mori. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Epidemiology, Rita Beal. Poluso Ishola. Jill Korsiak. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Experimental Medicine, Aaron Cho. Kevin Como. Stephen Findlay. Noor Gadar. Joey Heath. Samantha Latremui. Kiran McHaney. Juan Carlos Padilla Antunez. Edgar Pinedo Carpio. Stephanie Totten, also receiving a Doctor of Medicine and Master of Surgery. Oro Uchenunu. Motahare Vamegasta Tabani. Jinhyu Yi. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Experimental Surgery, Daniel Bisson. Theodora Dumitra. Shin Su. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Family Medicine and Primary Care, Reem El Sharif. Doa Farid. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy in Human Genetics, Sabrina Alam. Wejjan Alanizi. Luke Anderson Trokme. Le Chang. Caitlin Fearheller. Ali Mehdi. Gabrielle Perron. Mariam Razay Dashtarzane. Jay Ross. For the degree of Master of Engineering in Biological and Biomedical Engineering, Johnny Derhovajimian. Royan Jafari. Ashlyn Leung. Omer Pesa Chavez. Alda Profka. Mila Rosevit. William Wu. Vicky Zhu. For the degree of Master of Science in Biostatistics, Lily Shafetz. Pa Sala Drame. Gabrielle Virgili Gervais. Mingxi Chu. For the degree of Master of Science in Epidemiology, Lavanya Huria. Samuel Iguiokpala. Mikashmi Kolji. Shirley Lee. Stefan Robitaille. Angelina Sassy. Olalula Sule. Sydney Westra. For the degree of Master of Science in Experimental Medicine, Farah Al-Huda. Bayan Alaktar. K. Kiran Arumugam. Sanaz Azizi. Sophia Bourgeois. Michelle Chen. Meredith Elisiu. Ademola Esomojumi. Ryan Hanula. Nazila Hassanabadi. Catherine Hunt. Qiyang Liu. Laura Rico. Gunel Valikanova. Nicholas Wong. Michael Zhu. For the degree of Master of Science in Experimental Surgery, Noor Abu Hamdan. Tariq Al-Saadi. Mustafa Al-Habubi. Juliana Cavalcante de Mora. Yehuda Chokron. Dina El-Jarudi. Janatul Ferdus.
Thank you.
Julia Ferreira. Gargi Goel. Alia Hamuda. Chang He. Drew Harrigan, also receiving a graduate certificate in surgical innovation. Adam Hoffman. Audrey Pitaru. Arash Rad. Diksha Reddy. Stephanie Sirmakesian. Gabriela Spacania. David Tejera. Arturo Vela Lasagabaster. Oliver Wu Martinez. For the degree of Master of Science in Family Medicine, Amina Amin. Puria Gadiri. Marwa Ilali. Minika Ohayoma. For the degree of Master of Science in Genetic Counseling, Yasmin D'Souza. Miriam Fontaine. Jude Kawar. Mathieu Lessard. Stella McDonald. For the degree of Master of Science in Human Genetics, Engjin Batdorj. Welcome. Michelle Carter. Shane Feinstein. David Lockheed. Edgar Martinez Dunker Reboledo. Samantha Robinson. Carolina Skowronek. Evelyn Zavacki. For the degree of Master of Science in Medical Radiation Physics, Norm Mackay. For the degree of Master of Science in Pathology, Emma Rose Cheatham. For the degree of Master of Science in Psychiatry, Katie Bodenstein. Michaela Burke. Tiffany Harrington. Ayessa Nassar. Nezreen Ramouni. Mandy Wu. For the degree of Master of Science in Public Health, Ekundayo Afuape. Sinyi Baragar. Urgen Baraka. Andres Barrera Patlan. Ibtisam Budi. Megan Butler. Maureen Churipu. Sanya Dalal. Tudor Dino. Levi Urwala. Sanaev Faraji. Marisa Fazio. Daniela Fleming. Fresgi Grebeweldi. Diana Gibson. Nadia Gonzalez. Paula Gruber. Kieran Holmes. Brittany James. Narisa Carmali. Rasha Lacroof. Rina Lal. Wanjin Lee. Jacqueline Modler. Nora Moidu. Sukaina Wizan. Vivian Chang. Manuela Reves. Camille Roberge. Patrick Sambu. Claire Semelhago. Joyeuse Senga. Rosemary Shepherd. Harsimran Sidhu. Katrina Streif. Josh Swain, McCall McBain Scholar. Jingyi Tian. Parker Tope. Miranda Zari. Hannah Zhang. For the degree of Master of Science Applied in Occupational Health Sciences, Carla Almeida Torres. Abdul Hanan. Monica Nguyen. Weifeng Yu. For the Graduate Diploma in Clinical Research, Amélie Ibrahim. Zara Kusairi. For the Graduate Diploma in Oncology, Andra Lian. Melissa Tashjian. For the Graduate Certificate in Translational Biomedical Engineering, Jay Dondani. Pooja Harshan. Nurjot Sandhu. In case you need to ask, for the degree of Doctor of Medicine and Master of Surgery, Joanne Abi Jaude. Kadiam Al-Rubai. Mirtujaya Arjun Alpakam Govindarajan. Abdulla Albagjati. Puria Alipur. Jad Alkas. Sarah Amirali Carmali, Dean's Honor List. Ryan Antel, Dean's Honor List. Brandon Arulanandam, Dean's Honor List. Natasha Barone. Kaylee Beveridge. Siren Belanid. Sébastien Béliveau. Libby Benzvi. Lee Benaroche. Joshua Benchaya. Diana Benea, Dean's Honor List. Ariane Bergeron. Miranda Bird. Vanessa Bisson-Gervais. Erica Bitektin. Maria Bogachenko. Karim Botros. Asem Busena. David Buhadana. Isabella Bozzo, Dean's Honor List. Olivier Buron. Andréane Busque. Adario Chirguin Dasgupta. Liam Cooper Brown. Edith Corriveau Parenteau. Matei Kotoros Petroulian. Victoria Courgeon. Maud Crevier. Marie-Ève Cyr. Kathleen Daguano. Matthew Dankner. Also receiving a Doctor of Philosophy in Experimental Medicine. Rose Dioria. Catherine Drummond. Laurie Rose Dubé. Rob Dubé. Beatrice Dupont. Félix David. Vincent Dupont. François Fabi. Nardin Farag. Zara Farhour. Marie-Jeanne Fradette. Rana Gafar. Naomi Gendron. Dominique Geffrion. Miriam Gladstone. Morgan Gold. Emily Gros-Boivin, Dean's Honor List. Guido Guberman, also receiving a Doctor of Philosophy in Neuroscience. Amelia Hagdust. Brandon Hall, Dean's Honor List. Victoria Heyman, Dean's Honor List. Sukaina Huig. Naurin Hook. Jiayin Wang. Kellyanne Hutchinson. Alexandru Ili, Dean's Honor List. Hajar Iraqi, Dean's Honor List. Jenny Jing. Dana Kablawi. Yasmin Kerduli. Hasib Khan. Minahil Khan. Megan Khoury. Raphael Lafortune. Gabriella Leblanc. Bertrand Leduc. Dylan Lee. Julien Lemay. Charles Lepage. Jeremy Levitt. Joseph Levin. Junyang Liu. Justin Pierre Lorange, Dean's Honor List. Owen Luo, Dean's Honor List. Jack Luo. Divlin Malhi. Alejandra Martinez. Sumaira Mazhar. Frederic Yvon McAuliffe. Andrew Meng. Andrew Miller. Joseph Mouryousef Abitbol. Paul Musée. David Nassim. Alex Nguyen. Anshuan Lan Nguyen. Dean Nutsios, Dean's Honor List. Caitlin Nuchterline. Noah Waknin. Pierre-Luc Parent. Devangi Patel. Dylan Patel. Emily Pichette. Laura Pinkham. Marianne Plourde. Joseph Pozel. Céline Prell. Hannah Randolph. Nilab Rastogi. Camille Riopel. Mathilde Robitaille. Dennis Rompotinos. Amira Ruapi. Human Safa. Mitchell Sacklas, Dean's Honor List. Samer Salame. Ashkan Salehi. Eleonora Sargi. Emily Sarid. Solomon Sasson. Eliana Sattler. Noemi Sauvé. Victoria Sebag. Sarah Siddi. Artega Selvarajan. Alexander Shalai. Alice Shen. Lina Siafa, Dean's Honor List. Daniel Sikorsky. Alex Silver. Alex Simar. Jeffrey Siofi, Dean's Honor List. Sahar Sudbaksh. Safiya Sulan. Juliette Saint-Georges. Miriam Stefan. Rachel Swimmer. Jeremy Tellier, Dean's Honor List. Michael Teutenberg. Shaoni Ton Leclerc, Dean's Honor List. Victor Tran. Megan Traversi Drolet. Finance Genevieve Trudel Jurashi. Chris Valenti. Taraniya Valipuram. Eden Vandevanter. Spandana Viravalli. Benson Wan. Sarah Michelle Weinman. Emily Wu. Yanbo Yang. Linda Zhu.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
They made it. It's great. Thank you, Dr. Benaroya, for reading all the graduates' names. I now invite the Dean of Medicine, Dr. Eidelman, to the podium to lead the graduating class in reading of the oath for medical practitioners. David?
Please open your book, your program booklet to the Sponsio Academica, assuming you have a booklet. And I'm going to ask all health professional graduates to rise, please. And we're going to say the sponsio together. I'll begin.
Je déclare solennellement devant tous ceux ici rassemblés que je m'acquitterai de mon devoir en me laissant guider par les principes de ce serment que je prête librement et publiquement.
That I will diligently minister as much as in me lies to the comfort and restoration of the sick entrusted to my care, that I will not divulge without grave reason anything which I have either seen or heard during my professional attendance which it may be proper to conceal. Je m'engage en outre à exercer mes fonctions avec soin et fidèlement aux plus hautes traditions des codes éthiques de ma profession, and that as long as I may serve, I will ever seek to promote excellence in every act that I perform. Thank you. You may be seated.
Thank you, Dean Eidelman. I now invite Sebastian Bellevaux from the class to say a few words on behalf of the graduating class 2023 as 2023 valedictorian.
Chancellor, members of the platform party, fellow graduates and guests, it's an honor to be here with you today as valedictorian. But before I drift into a soliloquy, I want to just start by saying, hi, Mom. Surprise. Okay, now back to business. So here we are together at the finish line. Congratulations. I'm sure we can all agree that the road has been a challenging one and potentially a little wonkier than expected when we started years ago, owing to some strangeness in March of 2020. But nonetheless, here we are. Our loved ones and us alike have sacrificed so much in order for us to pursue this dream. Be proud of all the hard work, determination, and perseverance that each and every one of you has demonstrated, culminating in this auspicious day. Good job. By virtue of the degrees and titles bestowed onto us today, we join a privileged few who have had the opportunity to gain the knowledge and skills that we now possess. Through our efforts, we have been imparted with the tools to make a difference in the world. We've also gained a deeper understanding of the world and how it's becoming ever more complex and intertwined. As scientists, we have a responsibility to work together to address the great challenges of our time: social inequity, future pandemics, climate change. Complex problems have no easy fix. But as we've learned over these challenging years, difficult pursuits are all well worthwhile in the long run. I urge you to let the humanism that motivated you towards a career in health science to continue to guide you. So congratulations again, my fellow graduates, on this momentous achievement. We've worked hard to get to this point, but the real work has only just begun. Now, be bold, be conscientious, be kind. Merci beaucoup.
Merci, Sébastien. Thank you, Sébastien, on behalf of your class. Now I'd like actually all the graduating class please to stand. Je demande tous les diplômés de se lever. Thank you, yeah, good, checking. So, see everybody standing? In my capacity as Chancellor of McGill University, I declare and confirm that each of you is now entitled to the distinction of the degree, diploma, or certificate that has been conferred upon you with all the honors, rights, privileges, and responsibilities that are pertinent thereto. À titre de chancelier de l'Université McGill, je déclare et confirme que chacun de vous a maintenant le droit à la distinction de grade, diplôme ou certificat qui vous a été conféré, avec tous les honneurs, droits, privilèges et responsabilités qui y sont rattachés. Félicitations, congratulations.
You may be seated.
I will now ask Edita Rogowska, I know, to now make a few closing remarks. Edita?
Thank you, Mr. Chancellor. Dear graduates, in this moment marking the end of one chapter and the beginning of a new one, I'd like to leave you with a few words from one of McGill's most eminent medical graduates and members of the McGill Medical Faculty, Sir William Osler. In 1904, Dr. Osler said the following to a group of graduates: "Live neither in the past nor in the future, but let each day absorb your interest, energy, and enthusiasm. For the best preparation for tomorrow is to do today's work superbly well. Alors, votre éducation vous a bien préparé à répondre aux défis médicaux et sociaux les plus pressants de notre temps. Maintenant, c'est à vous d'utiliser tout ce que vous avez appris pour faire du bien. Le monde vous attend et compte sur vos contributions. Alors, bonne chance et félicitations encore une fois.
Merci, Edita. Pour conclure la cérémonie, voulez-vous lever afin d'étonner, en compagnie de Professeur Trevino, l'hymne national du Canada, please stand for the Canadian National Anthem done by Professor Trevino. Explore.
Canada, we stand on guard for.